In the water unit, there are two venturi valves, one for each suction cannula. Air or water is introduced from above the valve. This creates a strong depression inside the valve and generates a vacuum in the suction cannula tube. Everything that enters the valve is sent to the base of the dental unit through the drainage tubes, one for each valve. The yellow tube brings air to the air switches in the tray. Once the cannula is taken out, the air comes back to the orange tube. That arrives here where it activates the air flush in this tube. This allows the suction cannula to work. The system works using both air or water. Start checking from the beginning of the old system, from this tube that brings air to the switches in the tray. Check if the air arrives here. When a switch is released, it allows the air flush to pass inside it. Check if the air arrives in the two orange tubes. When the air valve or the water valve is activated, air or water comes out very strong from here. If not, then there is a problem before this point. Another thing you can check is the cannula filters. They may not be cleaned well. The last check you can do is to see if the air or water pressure is properly adjusted. You can control it at the base of the dental unit. There are two valves. The right pressure for the air is 5 to 6 bar, and at least 3 bar for the water. The problem could be the venturi valve, but this is really rare. We recommend using a bigger compressor for a dental unit with two venturi air valves. It needs more air. Thanks for watching. Be simple, be smart.